Hello everyone, I'm Akansha Arora, Faculty of Journalism and Mass Communication from Technion Institute of Advanced Study. Today I'm sharing my thoughts on major poverty aviation's programs in India. The six major poverty aviation's programs are as follows. A number of programs have been initiated to tackle the problem of poverty, especially for the rural sector. First, Integrated Rural Development Program was initiated October 2, 1980. The program has been designed in a manner that the benefits flow to a protest as the first priority. The small farmers get subsidy of 25% of the capital cost, while of the marginal farmers share is 33%. The landless laborers and rulers, acutals, entitled 50% of subsidy for a acquisition of assets. The program helped set to generate income of rupees 2000 per family. However, October 2, 1980, the program has been designed in a manner that the benefits flow to the protest as the first priority. The smallest farmers get subsidy of 25% of the capital cost, while the marginal farmers share is 33%. The landless labor and the rural acutists are entitled to a 50% subsidy for acquisition assets. The program has set out to generate income of rupees 2000 per family. However, mid-term appraisal of the 9th plan revealed that the average investment per family remained too inadequate to generate the target income per family. The success of the program would have been much higher but for the fact that selection of the families is not always guided by the economic and business consideration, where the selected family does not have the requisite aptitude and ability to manage. The gains have not been commensurate with the subsidy made available under the plan. Presently, all families having an annual income below 11,000 have been made eighth of assistance under IRDP. By the end of the 8th plan period, over 89 lakhs families had been assisted. 50% of families of the beneficiaries were SC/ST. However, the target of assisting 40% women could not be achieved. Second point, National Rural Employment Program is the new name for the original Food Work for Work program. It is certainly sponsored with the central government providing 50% assistance under the program. The target is to create additional employment for the order 300 to 400 million men days annually. The beneficiaries are to be unemployed and under the employed person also. A critical assessment of the performance under the plan shows that while funds are put in the programs, liberally, the output in terms of employment generation remains well below the target. The employment provided is of short duration and the wages paid are less than prevailing market rates. Even the selection of beneficiaries is not always above board. Advertisement. The most common works undertaken under the program and development of cut roads within the village. The states are required to contribute 50% of the total rural plan expenditure out of their resources. But what the states have been doing is that instead of pumping new funds, the existing programs of the Public Works Department are shown as work under the NREP. In some cases, the funds are spent over construction involving high period material components. In such cases, to the basic purpose of utilizing locally available material and labor gets defeated Third point, Rural Landless Employment Generate Program launched in August 1983 is a supplement to a NREP. Under the program, the wages of landless laborers are paid partly in money and poverty, partly in food gains also. The projects under the program are undertaken during the days there is not much to do on the farms. The idea behind the program is that at least one member from each landless family should be provided with 100 days of gainful employment. The projects undertake the program included employment of minor immigration facility, reclamation of waste land, social forestry, and soil consumption. The other projects covered under the program included Indira Awas Yojana and the Million Wheels Scheme, NREP, have made overlapping areas. It is now proposed to merge the two programs. Fourth point, Jawahar Rozgar Yojana is implemented through the Agency of Village Panchayats. The central government provides 80% finance and the state's share is a bare 20%. Funds are allocated to the village panchayats in proportion to the size of population living below the poverty line. The target is to provide 50 to 100 days of employment to at least one member of the family, every poor family, within the village with a 30% reservation for women. It is assumed that 50% of the houses constructed under the Jawahar Rozgar Yojana were of good quality. The average cost of per house came to around ₹13,543. The expenditure has since been increased to ₹20,000 to cover cost acceleration for improving further the quality of construction work. Rural roads accounted for 33% to the rural total expenditure. Another 9% was spent on the minor irrigation projects. Other beneficiary includes social forestry and schools and community building like panchayat halls. The impact of the Jawahar Rozgar Yojana is creating additional employment has not been satisfactory. While the target was to create 100 days of employment, the achieved target has been just 11 days. These programs have indirect positive fallout. With more money available from consumption in the rural sector, there is an increase in the rural consumption expenditure. This increased expenditure also help in creating new demands and constantly employment assistance scheme was introduced in October 1993. The aim of the scheme was to provide 100 days of unskilled manual work to a rural poor people. All men and women above 18 of age were intended to be covered under the scheme. However, the achieved target was only 413 days in a year. Fifth point, Swarn Jayanti Gram Swaraj Yojana was launched in April 1999. Million Wealth Schemes and development of women and children in rural areas have been merged in the scheme. The scheme attempts to combine bank loans and subsidy with a view to enable the benefits to create income generating assets. There is a monetary limit for subsidy in case of irrigation projects. In other cases, however, the subsidy is limited to 30%, subject to maximum of ₹7,500. A higher limit of 10,000 has been prescribed for SC/ST beneficiaries. The states have to contribute just 25% while the rest of the funds are being provided by the central government. 6. Jawahar Gram Samriddhi Yojana is the restricted form of earlier Jawahar Rozgar Yojana. It aims at generating additional employment opportunity for the unemployed poor in the rural sector. Wage employment is limited to those under poverty line. The scheme aims at creating village infrastructure and durable assets at a village level, such that additional opportunity for sustained employment and generate. That's all from my side. I hope this lecture will help you understand this topic. Thank you very much.